So namaste from my rhododendron forest hills of home. Today we have a very talented, very renowned, very celebrated, let me call social engineer, this new term I have heard. And he has made us, through him I have traveled NASA. I used to follow him even on social media, and he prior to this he shared me so many things, and he has created, innovated so many, discovered so many devices which is helpful for mankind. And being so young engineer, he can be a brilliant innovator. Let's me introduce you to he had been to NASA's workshop recently also, right? And he's traveling internationally, and let him share his share stories and his experiences and what he has for a gift as a innovator to the society, to the mankind as a whole. So Neil Talukdar, welcome. I'm so happy to meet you. Give me a handshake. Corona times, we are safe. So,
I think from the very school days itself, I was more into doing things that can help the masses. And when you're young, you have many role models. I think I started my role model from my parents itself.
Okay, your parents are role models.
Yes, because I've seen the struggle. And one good advantage of being an Indian citizen is we all have a role model as our parents in our daily house, daily lifestyle. But we fail to acknowledge that many of the times.
True, very true.
So, my foundation, if I say, has values at the beginning. But I was lucky enough to have a vision. And when I talk about vision, it's not only that career goal that I'm talking about. I'm talking about that, do you want to survive as a selfish person or individual, or do you want to be a selfless person? But then again, maintaining the sustainability on the way. Because if you have knowledge, you can sell it as a service, as a consultant, as an employee.
That's marketing point of view. Mankind point of view. Is.
True. But then again, you can survive, you can sustain while doing social service as well. And social service did not mean only philanthropic point of view. Only, you know, giving away money.
Uh-huh.
That's sympathy. But when you are empathetic on your values and you want to do something good, the technical layout comes when you go for academic studies. That academic study can be self, Google online classes or any other platforms, or you go through an academic platform or institution. In grade 11, 12, I vividly remember when I worked on my first scientific project. It was about a...
You were in standard grade 11?
Grade 11, yeah, grade 11. So, it was about a device that can assist the individuals who are specially gifted, and particularly the ones who do not have the upper limbs. So if I'm paralyzed from my upper limbs, then many of the activities are very difficult for me to perform, right?
They use prosthetic hands.
They use, yeah. But it's
but not
accurate
possible.
For turning pages.
Okay, okay. So turning pages.
Turning book pages, right?
Okay.
Because I may not be able to give them their hands, and if I really have to work on biotechnology, and that's a different level of activity. But being in grade 11, what I thought is that during that time, there was not much of electrical assistance being available, or voice commands, it was not there during that time. So I thought, why not build a manual device that is low cost, can be made by anyone, and it can be replicated by anyone in a village also. Being from Guwahati, I have to think, person from Himaji, if they have to replicate the concept, right? So, the device...
Grassroot, right?
The grassroot, definitely.
The thinking global as well as the grassroot.
Yeah. So,
mankind means that.
Yeah, definitely. Because it's like simplicity at its best. But it took me some time. And we have to understand one thing, that if I can be successful, anyone else also can. Because in my case, I was specific about time management. Because I'm from a lower middle class family. I have to look after the financial part. I cannot just go about my dreams. Because that would be selfish for me, being a senior sibling in the family. But after school hours, if I can take out some time, if I study in the school hours, and after school hours, if I take some time, learn the skills, I used to go to carpentry shops, I used to go to welding shops, and I do like part-time jobs over there. That's how I learned the skill, like the art and craft.
Small things also you need on the way to learn.
Definitely.
Okay, that helps you create big things.
Obviously, because like if you do not
welding
know,
even the shopkeepers spots for roadside, yeah, there, yeah, you yeah. have included them also,
yes,
in your,
yes, yes, yes.
Mission, dreams,
yeah,
imagination.
Yeah, yes, yes.
They must they have an
yeah.
inspiration for you also,
true,
right?
True, true. And it's a boastful thing.
But people say that Abdul Kalam inspiration is Isaac Newton. Aap to welding machine wale, carpenter wale. Very good. And you demo, you were in Rashtrapati Bhavan also.
Yes, yes. So after I created the project, I was lucky enough that I got media attention. And there is, and at times we blame the media for not highlighting the articles or not highlighting the stories, but it's not always like that. You might not come in the first page, but there are good journalists as well, I have seen. And some of them were kind enough
it
to...
It depends upon the... You may be a journalist, you may be a writer. It depends upon the individual,
yes, yes,
how
yes.
he is, how much interested in his stories, innovative,
definitely.
And, you know, intriguing and inspiring stories like this. You will run for after
yeah,
that, right?
Definitely. And then when I was in school going for competitions, I happened to meet a lot of journalists. And in a very funny point, the journalists were the ones who gave me a lot of ideas about the competitions. And these many of them told
me. The animals are
me.
Loving you.
Okay.
Chicken self, huh?
So it's like most of the journalists.
This is George,
shared...
George Orwell's Animal House also.
Yeah.
My house. Sorry.
For that. This is exactly. So many journalists also helped me on the way and they. Gave me direction, you should apply for this, you should apply for that. And I then applied for Ignite Award. That was given by late Dr. Abdul Kalam.
Abdul Kalam.
Yeah, so he gave me the award. It was 2014. So that was in IIM Ahmedabad.
Okay.
Thereafter, since I was continuing my journey, then I was selected as an innovation scholar in President's House in 2016. That same year, I went for NASA's project also. And I went for
what
my first...
What you did in NASA? It's so interesting.
Okay, so NASA's project was all
NASA,
about...
NASA, say full form, but I in NASA, okay?
So, okay, so National Agency for Space Aeronautics.
Space Aeronautics.
Yes.
Now you will be carrying this device to space.
Yeah, yeah.
Very good.
So, so there, there was slight change of activities because basically I was invited come... Being given the
but
like
you
option to
say something about satellite also, you know.
No, actually, what happened is like when in 2017, if I talk about when I was like first assigned the projects. So my team that was we were given a specific project. We have to devise a machine that can operate on Mars or Moon.
On Moon.
We are talking about vehicles.
Oh my goodness.
We are talking about vehicles. Okay.
On
yeah.
your
so
projects are reaching on Moon.
Yes.
Wow.
So my first innovation was related.
Oh my goodness.
Was related to the specially gifted group.
Ah.
Then I upgraded or I was lucky enough to work on different projects thereafter. And we worked on space vehicles. We call it the moon buggy.
Moon
so,
buggy.
So if I have to explain the layman how what a moon buggy is, it's basically like in our planet Earth, we're talking about two-wheelers, we're talking bicycles, right? But we cannot ride bicycle on moon. So what is the alternative of any vehicle from one point to another? And that is manual. So that is called the moon buggy. So we, my team was there involved. Moon buggy is a concept that's been there for quite some time. But my team also, I was given assigned a team in Germany. There was a space institute over there. So we were given assignments, we were given teams. I was a team leader over there. So we designed vehicles that can operate on moon. And we created the same structure on the surface of the land itself. And we tested a lot of simulation was done. And it was successful. It was accepted. So thereafter, I started going for alien hunting, like research in that area. And I went for e-development activities. And mind you, okay, while I'm doing this, I'm still in my college.
What's your age?
Oh, my age? That's a million-dollar question.
20?
Okay. So I'm 25 now.
Oh my goodness.
So, yeah, so I just...
25 years old, I'm thinking and working for moon. You know, moon
yeah.
is my favorite subject.
Yes.
I'm a moon child.
Yes.
Astronomically, not astronautically. Thank
so,
you.
So I graduated last year only.
Okay.
And right now, I have around 5 companies running. So partly they are in education, partly they are in project management. And now
you
we are in variety of
activities. You are not only making India proud, but the whole world, yeah? You are
I don't like, I think I'm more of an experimental kind of guy.
How much this astronaut, our own Goswami, you know, astronaut, he helps you, I mean, inspires you?
Not likely because...
You also have a totally different mission and dream.
Yes, actually see, my ultimate goal is not for the outer space. So, if I have to be very specific, what's in the pipeline in the next 10 years, I'm talking about youth development.
Society and space, but it's
yes,
emerging, you
yes,
know, you're thinking
support.
For the space also,
yes, yes, yes.
might help you creating, create
true,
better
true.
Things for
yes,
society.
Yes, yes, yes.
It's like, you know, you're trying to people are thinking about, scientists are thinking about space, yes. And you are working for space, also for the society, you know, mankind, yes, history, yes. It's complete in itself, definitely. You know, very universal idea.
What I thought in the SMS community right now is like parents are a bit skeptical about exploring different activities, right? So,
I blame parents also, they restrict their imaginations.
It's two ways. Today's time I'm talking about, if the parents are not strict, most of the youths are definitely going to get lost. But if the youth is prominent enough and confident enough, right? Some way or the other, the student finds his way. Because there are enough examples and role models in Assam, I've seen myself,
who have defined morning, that. Morning shows the day. Morning itself, like, you know, young, youth.
Yeah.
When the child is... when you say morning shows the day, I mean a child's behavior, his activities, his habits will show his future, what type of, you know, or maybe change, yeah, it might change also. It depends on
the potential stays throughout the day.
Who they meet.
Yes.
Right? People inspire. If children meet people like you, in society we'll have no scientific minded people, you know, science background, who we are now, we'll have scientific minded, there will be no chaos, no war, no conflict. All innovation, discovery, everybody is happy, happy valley, like this happy valley.
Yes, definitely.
This
definitely
is under construction, but it's so happy actually. This place is very, you know, very soothing. Will you allow me to make a film out of your project, what you have discovered? What do you call that device?
So it's called page turning machine.
Food operated page turning machine for specially abled, right?
Yeah.
Show me. I'll go to your home. Want to do a research.
Okay,
No,
actually, those projects are in Ahmedabad now.
Okay.
So it's under government, research and R&D.
But you have shifted from here to Shaldi down to Ahmedabad.
No, actually, it's a government. They have taken up a couple of projects.
Okay.
So they are doing some R&D over there.
Are they helping you out?
Yes. Specialization. So I'm more confident about sharing my life lessons, because I have seen how students or youths are struggling to deal with their parents, how parents are not confident about students' decision, and what's the pathway.
That is motivational part of your through your experience. Yeah. People might not. But what about the machine now? Should we glorify the machine?
I think it's not.
What's the name of the machine basically?
It's called food operated manual page turning machine.
Food operated manual page turning machine. But do you have a name for the software, something like that?
I never thought of it.
Engineer ke naam pe hote hai na, maximum.
So because right now I'm working on the electrical version of it. There's an upgrade coming up.
Swapnil machine, something like you will have.
That's a good thing.
Maximum flower, for example, Bailey rhododendron was discovered by Bailey. So
yeah,
rhododendron,
yeah.
Bailey.
True.
Rhododendron, flower is like, you know, for example, rhododendron Raja was dedicated to Raja. So it's like rhododendron Raja, something like that. All scientists, whoever, not only scientists, whoever, botanists or explorers have discovered flower. All the flowers are based on their name. It's been named after them. So like what? The machine will also have your name, India. The film I'll be making on you, I'll just start dreaming about the beautiful title. You have Machine Man, Missile Man, some, you know, Foot Machine Man. Right? Something like that. I'll Foot Machine, Foot Machine Footprint, something like that, you know. Nice talking to you, Swapnil. We'll end here because we want to keep it in suspense. Why will we share all stories? And I'm so happy, engineer, social engineer, and almost like NASA scientist and innovator visited my sanctuary and this Happy Valley, my home. And animals also started have loving Swapnil. Look at the meow cat. And lots to share, lots to... I'm inspired, and through, you know, I'll invite sometime Swapnil also again to inspire us. And what he's so young, 25 years old, in 50 years, God knows what he'll create wonderful, the wonders of the world. And I wish Swapnil Talukdar the best of everything, best of blessing, best of my love, respect, everything. Thank you for coming.
Thank you so much, Rajesh.